Hi everyone, in this video we are going to see about Nifty breakout levels. By watching this video you can gain some knowledge about market. By watching this video you can also start to trade on your own. Those who are new to channel, kindly subscribe the channel and select the ring bell for continuous updates. If you feel like the video, kindly select the like button and share it. By selecting the name of this channel, NSC Commodity Trader, you will go to the homepage. In homepage you can see more strategy videos and indicator videos in playlist in Tamil and English languages. By watching these videos, you can gain more knowledge about market also. We are also taking more advanced trading strategies and we are also providing levels for commodity also. If you want to know about these details, means WhatsApp or contact the number in below video. Nifty. Nifty formed a bearish candle on Friday. It's a continuously 3-week doji candle as well. Let me show you past 3 weeks. In the past 3 weeks, this is past 3 week candles. In this past 3 weeks, as you can see, continuously third doji candle has been formed. It's showing as a market indecisiveness in the market. So it's, if you take a look at the point wise range, means you can see in the upper side the range is 12,030 and then the downside the range is 11,800. So it's just a 250 point trade is going on in the Nifty. So it's look like a more consolidation and more doji market. If you take a look at the day wise candle, means on Friday it opened above 11,950, but after it crossed 11,950 range, market started to falling down. During that fall it reached up to 11,880 range and then again made a little comeback at and closed above 11,900. But market is still in the range between 12,030 and then the downside you can see 11,800. So still Nifty has been in a range bound like a sideways market in the overall trend for short term position. For if you want to take any short term position, means this is not the right time to take any short term position in Nifty. And many experts are saying kindly avoid buy on dips also, because currently buy on dip strategy is not working well. But if you can go for sell on high strategy, like whenever a market moved above more, if it crossed above 50 points, like that means you can sell it and book, aim for some 30-40 points in the downside, because currently market is working on like that only. Okay, whenever market came near in the past week like a 12,000 range, means market started to falling down. It cannot able to hold this 12,000 range, as you can see in the past week performance. Okay, let's go for Monday. For Monday, the first level resistance will be the 11,950 range. First thing, market need to hold this 11,900 as well also. If market didn't hold 11,900, means you can expect some negativeness in the market. If it opened above 900 or it's seen some above 920 range, means you can go for buying Nifty, and you can expect for 11,950 will be the first level resistance. And it made a crossover of 11,050 also, means you can expect another 30 points in the Nifty also. But if it came near to 12,000, means you need to be cautious. If it didn't cross over the 12,000 range, means you can go for sell on high strategy. By selling it, you can expect another 40-30 points in the downside also. According to current market, like these strategies, like these movements only, it will be working. Nifty, like VIX, they will say its volatility also has been reduced to 15. So it's very, very less volatile in the current Nifty. So whenever news came, any fundamental news came only, means you can expect some positiveness or negativeness in the market. So the major resistance level is 12,030 and then the major supportive level is 11,800. In between these levels for intraday, so the 900, 950 will be the in between level, in between support and resistance for the Nifty on Monday. For stock, you can go for Z Entertainment, because Z Entertainment is performing very well because of fundamental news. That fundamental news is it will be like a foreign investors have bought around 4,000 crore rupees in this Z Entertainment. So it's a huge positive news, huge investment has been made on Z Entertainment. Due to that only you can see some the gap up shoot up to 330 range. So it's a short term, it's on positive trend also for Zee Entertainment. It's a huge fundamental news for Zee Entertainment also. So you can expect some positiveness in the for the short term in the market, okay, as well as for intraday also. And then the another stock that shoot up in the market on Friday is IDBI Bank. Up to 2:45 p.m. it is traded on 33 range only. After that, the IDBI Bank started to move up. It went up to the freezing level of 40.10 paisa. So it's a huge positiveness in the market, and the market also opened at closing price also in 38 range only. So it closed. So you can expect some positiveness in the IDBI on Monday also. You can trade on these two buying stocks for Monday. We are also taking more advanced trading strategy class, and we are also providing levels for commodity also. If you want to know about these details, means you can WhatsApp or contact the number. If you want to open a DMAT or trading account, you can call me or WhatsApp the number. In future, if you want to see more videos like this, means kindly subscribe my channel and select the ring bell. Thank you.